This is Roger Hansen, and I am doing a video or an audio test, I guess you'd say. Here, up until this point, I haven't used any audio mixers until now. I ended up going online last night and getting Audacity. It's an open source recording mixer, audio mixer, and right now I'm going through the manual and working on the audio. First, they had me take and set up a couple of things on the manual that is supposed to be helpful. I am right now recording and I'm starting to talk, and as long as I want is what it's telling me to do. And, when you feel you've recorded enough, it tells you to click stop. I need to also set up to where it goes from file export and it's immediately transported to a WAV or AIFF. And they suggest that I use an external drive. That's for a safety copy before I start editing the project. But this is what it sounds like with the audio mixer that I have. And the reason why I picked Audacity is because, like I said, it's open source and I support open source. You'll see a lot of people telling you about a lot of programs to use that cost you like $150 to $75, whatever, you know. But when you go into open source, you can really help support people who are trying to start programs and everything, and they do it for free. There is a chance, you know, threat that of viruses and stuff, but if you know your way around open source, you can pretty much figure out which ones to avoid and which ones not to. So this is what it sounds like with Audacity after going according to their manual and setting up. I'll show you some of the issues that I've had without a mixer. I'll add them onto the video as I go along so that we can all hear the differences, because I haven't heard it yet. I can hear it on the speakers, but I don't know what it's all about. Now, they told me too that whenever, and I didn't know this, but when you go to adjust your I guess your volume and everything on your recording, that you need to have at least 6 dBs, I guess they call it. And on here I can get just under 9. -6 is what they suggest, but I can get under 9 and everything, and I still have that echoing sound that I need to work on. I haven't made it through the editing yet, so I don't know. And I'm in the process now of trying to get a better look at the readings on here to find out what's going on. And I'm just basically doing recording at the moment so that I can check everything out, get it going. But this is going to be a part of my, this is going to be the second part of my audio and video, so that I can check out all of it. It says try to aim for a maximum peak of around 6 dB, and then 5 dB if you have your meter set to linear rather than dB. Okay. Now, after I do this, it says step 2, remove any DC offset. And DC offset can occur at the recording stage so that the recorded waveform is not centered on the horizontal line at 0.0 amplitude. This can be caused if you have a faulty sound card. If this is the case with your recording, see the normalized page for more use for how to use normalized to remove DC offset and how to check if your Windows sound card can perform this correctly automatically. Alright, so after this I go into editing recording. I will stop the recording now and I will play it back and see what it sounds like.
Hello.
Sound mixer or audio mixer. I also wanted to say that I tried to go in and fix the mess ups on the old footage, and at this moment I don't know if I can do it on here. So far I haven't found a way. That doesn't mean that it doesn't have a way on this one, but I checked it out and I can't do that. So basically the echo on that footage is there, so it's pretty much a ruined, you know, footage other than an example of what it sounded like. But I'm reading the manual and going through and figuring out how to work this audio, so at the moment I don't know for sure how well it actually is or what it, you know, what I need to do, so I can keep you tabs on that as I go. But this is my update, and hopefully with using this or this Audacity audio mixer, it'll help out. So far from what I've heard, it's pretty good. I also had to go in with the XSplitter and my computer's audio recording, and I had to disable my XSplitter from the speakers so that it wouldn't cause an echo, and it sounds like that's actually working out too. I don't hear the clicking sound that I'm getting without the mixer as well, and I noticed that is something that's wrong. I think that comes from the Behringer, because I've heard of certain complaints about, you know, frequencies and noises that come from it, so I still have to go in and look at the gain and figure out what that's all about and how I need to adjust it. So it's a work in progress for me. I also have mic tests whenever I use the wireless mic to go outside, and it created a lot of that static I got static in here with mic 2, and I haven't heard any static coming out of it, so I'm happy with that. I hope I can pull off doing, you know, live video and everything, but I don't know yet if I can pull that off with this audio mixer, but we'll find out. It's all something, stuff I have to work on, and I will get back to you. I'm going to have to add some video to go with this so you guys can see what I'm talking about. At the moment, I'm using my audio and my video separately until I get it a little bit more acquainted with all this and figure out what I'm doing. So I'm going to get off here and I'm going to add some video.
On my video resolution, I had to drop it down earlier. You couldn't even read the words because I had it down on 640 by 360 and I put it up to 854 by 480 this time. So just to do a comparison, I want to use my wireless mics, the Bowens, to see how they compare to the actual mic that plugs into the Behringer. I tried it once already and the volume was pretty low and there was a lot of static in it, so I'm going to give it a try this time. I did some changes on the settings and the microphone and speakers on the computer, and now I'm going to see what it sounds like.
Now this right here is with the mic that's plugged in. I just changed it over from the wireless. Now on the monitor, what you're seeing there is I have the X splitter on there, and the reason why I did that was because I wanted to show you guys that I dropped the resolution down to 640, I believe, and it caused problems with the visuals to where you couldn't see what's on the screen, so I moved it up to 854 by 480. And I also wanted to mention some stuff about the project rate for Hertz. They suggested to put my Hertz on 44 or 100, the sample rate. And Hertz defines the number of digital audio samples per second taken from continuous analog signal. 44/100 Hertz is standard for creating files that can be turned into audio, CD, or high quality MP3 files. So I did that, but there was one thing that I had an issue with that I was able to put it on 44/100 Hertz, but like they say here, 32-bit float, I had to drop mine down to 16-bit because my computer's older and I can only use 16-bit, but we'll see how it works. It shouldn't be that big of a deal. Now, with the rest of it is just basically to catch up on and let you guys know how I've been going. And other than doing the resolution on the X splitter, I also had to go through and cut my my audio and everything from, and my recording from my X splitter, so that it didn't do the echo. And on this overdub, I was told too that I needed to take and turn the take the check mark off the overdub because it actually affects your recording. Now it says now click on the transparent menu again and make sure that overdub is not checked. When this option is enabled, Audacity will play other existing tracks while recording a new one. You can decide which track will play according. And that actually is a pretty good idea. And these are kind of what it looks like on here.